Kuzampola. Namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online Ayurveda and Yoga workshops. Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR's Nehru Wangchuk Culture Center. Yoga teacher, I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My sincere prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties and the whole Bhutan. And today, a kind of special day in the history of India, that is Indian Council for Cultural Relations, established in 1950s on the concept, on the great message of the whole world is one family, Vasudhaivaka Kutumbakam. Basically, ICCR was founded in 1950 by India's first education minister, Sri Maulana Abul Kalam Azad ji, to strengthening or to bonding or to give good relationships and to spread love and mutual understanding between India and the world. And what we call ICCR, and ICCR has well-designed programs belongs to Indian art and oral traditions and Indian classical dance, Indian classical music, in Indian classical yoga and Indian languages and food and Indian festivals and contemporary arts and contemporary issues. In ICCR, we have many other different scholarships also available, for especially for the foreign students, to give more understanding on the Indian culture and Indian traditions. So on this auspicious day in the history of India, ICCR Foundation Day, my best wishes to you all. Okay, now coming to actually recitation, this recitation actually from the Bhagavad Gita. It is saying that the balance about the in affairing in the food in regarding health. Yukta hara viharasya, yukta chestasya karmasu, yukta sopnava bhodasya, yogo bhavati dukkaha. Like whatever we are doing in our regular practices, in regarding food, in regarding exercises, in regarding everything, we have to be follow the way of balance. What we call madhye marga, the balance. If balance will be change its positions, now it will be imbalances. It will create further issues, stress, depression, physical health damages and mental health damages, even in the social health also. It will not be sure that if people will not be doing the actual instructions, if they will not really proceedings properly, the government instructions or the rules and regulations, obviously social health also will be spoiled. So in this regard, again, I would like to give some small notes about the COVID protocols. So always try to follow physical distancing and always carry your mask even though you are having vaccinations. And do not touch any surfaces outside, and please come to the one important point called do not count currency notes or do not count papers by touching your tongue. As well as hand hygiene and respiratory hygiene also very important. Carry your hand sanitizers. Especially respiratory hygiene is very important in this tough season. Especially when you are entered into the home from the outside, I think it can be possible. Please leave your shoes outside only. And at the same time, try to have a small stool or bench and have your one kind of steam inhalation device, and try to follow that steam inhalation just outside of the home, and after that get into your home. Because this is a very simple technique to get rid of these viral cells, because viral cells are laying at least 2 to 3 days in the paranasal cavities or parasinal cavities. So through only steam inhalation only, it will be killed properly. Please remember this steam inhalation technique. Then second one is throat goggling, estimadu powder or salt water or tripala powder. You can use plain hot water also, or you can use any of these ingredients called estimadu powder, or you can use tripala powder, or you can use salt also to clean the throat. Next one is healthy sleep, also very important to rejuvenate the body. 6 to 8 hours sleep required, but one more hour or 1.5 hour required when you are more active in your works. Vitamin A, vitamin D and zinc based diets also very important. It will boost up the immunity, which are available in local fresh green leafy vegetables, fruits, nuts, so-called things. And next one is cloves therapy, cloves powder and honey with the hot milk or hot water early in the morning once. And in the evening also, you can take this simple cloves therapy to get rid of the phlegm disorders which will be deposited around the throat. And the next one is home kitchen remedies called jaggery or honey or what we call ilachi and pepper, cinnamon, cumin, coriander, garlic and jaljeera powder and asafoetida, hing. Next one, these are very simple and effective home remedies. So in your regular diet items, please use these practices. And coming to two important drinks, health tonics called kadachai preparation. Next one is golden milk preparation. Kadachai preparation, many times I have given my important notes on this kadachai. In future also we will see the kadachai preparation, but that's also very good tonic to immunity boosting. And next one is golden milk preparation, also very important, especially while in the evenings, this golden milk preparation so suitable. So next one is local shilajit and local cordyceps, also very important to boost up the immunity. And chyawanprash also important, so it has nearly 45 different kind of Ayurvedic herbs. So according to your free times, according to your convenience and according to your health condition, you can choose these applications to boost up your immunity. And as we know that in this week, today is our last day to see these Ayurvedic practices, like what we are seeing to in this week called arthritis. So whatever the conditions you have, arthritis because of heredity, because of low immunity, because of other kind of drugs and steroids and other kind of any other things. Like in Ayurveda, we have a definite practices to trigger or to encounter this kind of arthritis issues. So here I can I want to stress another important notes on this Ayurvedic drugs which will be available for the arthritis. So what we call Swarna Bhasma or Rajita Bhasma, it's a kind of smoke from the gold. It's an Ayurvedic processed smoke. That's very important to boost up the immunity, not only that, to strengthening the skeleton system, as well as it will totally good for your internal wind related issues. Next one is Ashwagandha, very important, and Arjuna also very important, and Dhanvantari Taila, Mahanarayan Taila also very important. Bruhad Vata Chintamani also very important to level the internal wind related issues, as well as Vidvamsa, Vata Vidvamsini Ras also very important. Next one is Dasamula Kashaya also very important. These are different Ayurvedic ingredients available in the online, available in the markets also. According to your doctor's advice, you can use these practices. But please remember, when you have your English medicine, you can use Ayurvedic medicines also. It has no clash in between these two medicines. So next one is Yogi Raja Gugulu or Simhanada Gugulu or Amrita Gugulu, also very important to level these three doshas inside. And today's important four Ayurvedic remedies are, first thing is, as we mentioned before, that Trikatu and Tripala. Trikatu, in the morning you can choose Trikatu tonic only once, 10 ml or 5 ml to 10 ml in 100 ml of water or milk early in the morning. And in the evenings or before bed, Tripala Kashai, it is a kind of Ayurvedic three important fruits. It's a mixture of Ayurvedic three important fruits. Before going to bed, Tripala will work properly, especially the people who are having this wind related issues. So next one is Anjir. Anjir fruit powder early in the morning with hot milk or hot water. So before breakfast, empty stomach, please take this solution to clear passages, intestinal passages, as well as it can what we call structure the wind levels. Next one is dry plums, also very important. It can cure constipation, as well as it can give proper balance to the wind level issues. So next one is dry apricot or apricot fruit powder form or plain fruit. So here also I'm giving stress on these important four: Tripala or Trikatu, Anjir and dry plums, as well as dry apricots. In a day, try to see how you can use these simple practices. But when you have this kind of arthritis issues or any bone related issues, please try to avoid or lower the levels of salt and peas and green peas, both, and spicy items and curd and jaggery, and as well as all sea products including dry fish, even spirulina, chlorella also, single cell protein, that's actually from the oceans. So try to avoid them also. Next one is palm oil. Please avoid palm oil, and please avoid sour items, and please avoid all tough salts and tough proteins and tough fats inside the food. Next one is, as anyhow, for the arthritis conditions, smoking and alcohols are it's a deadly agents. Please avoid them properly. And maize, and as well as soya, and next one is black gram. These are also having it will create some imbalance to the inside wind. So try to avoid this one at least till you will be recovered from these arthritis issues. But arthritis is not a disease. It's also like a disorder. It can be easily manageable through traditional practices, through Ayurveda and through yoga. When we are meeting here at the same place, same topic on Monday, we will see still more good applications on other important element. So let's coming to the yoga class now. And sun salutation is our regular practices. So according to your time limit, according to your physical fitness and condition, you can choose sun salutations. Or else if you have any issues, especially arthritis or bone related issues, some of the posters may not recommend it to the people who are having this kind of issues. But please take advice from your yoga teacher as well as from the physician also before adding this yoga practices in your regular schedules. And please remember, weightlifting or jogging or cycling also restricted. Please don't do them when you have any bone related issues. Okay, coming to the actually practices, sun salutations, we have mantra chanting and sloka and bija akshara. According to your traditional belief, you can follow these chantings or you can follow only physical practices. Then inhalations, lift your both the arms up above to the head called Kailash Mudra, and from there Kailash Mudra down towards the chest called Anahata Pranamasan. Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasyapi Hitam Mukham Tattvam Pushan Apavrunu Satya Dharmaya Drushtaye. Om Hram Hrim Hrum Hram Raha Mitra Ravisurya Bhanu Kagapushna Hiranya Gadbhamaricha Aditya Savitra Arka Bhaskaraya Namaha. Stretch your arms forward, lift your arms up. And once pull up, and from there slightly put a back bend at the chandra or at the chakra, then again keep your body straight. When you have lower back issues or heart ailments or blood pressure issues or ear or head issues, avoid all kind of forward bends. But remaining people can do this Padahastasana till the floor or till the toes and completely bend the body, keep your head inside. And right leg is your back leg here, Aswa Sancharanasana or horse riding posture. When you have knee issues or hip girdle issues or ankle issues, choose proper way of doing. Now back leg straight on the toes and join your forward leg to back leg called Dandasana or Santulanasana. Again stay for a while here and very slowly bend the body down towards the floor called Ashtanga Namaskarasana or Sashtanga Namaskarasana. Like a sea wave, lift the body up and completely stretch your neck and come to the lifted head cobra posture called Bhujangasana. Very simple posture to manage many kind of lower back issues and neck issues. And back leg straight on the toes and push your body inside called Parvatasana, mountain triangular posture. And here right leg is your again forward leg called Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding posture. And then slowly back leg straight on the toes and back leg knee up against the gravity, then slowly join your back leg to forward leg called Padahastasana. And lift your arms and the body up, Hasta Uttanasana. Once completely pull yourself up and slightly put a back bend called Ardha Chandra or Ardha Chakra. Again keep your body straight, Pranamasana above to the head, then very slowly bring your Pranamasana down at your chest called Anahata Pranamasana. Then after that lift your both the arms and very slowly wide your arms and very slowly rest your hands. And relaxations enough, long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Okay, now today's our yoga postures will be one is squatting posture, then second one is in the same squatting posture kona variation, then third one is Sirshasana also we are doing. So according to your physical condition, you can choose proper way of doing. So let's coming to the simple exercise, simple posture squatting. So keep your both the legs almost together, or you can put a slight gap in between your feet. Now here, long and slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. And coming to like both the legs almost together, called squatting posture, Utkutasana. So here we have two variations. One is arms forward and one is arms up. So you can choose any arm balance, but basically is you have to bring your body down on the base of knee bends. All right, open your hands forward. Then try to bend your both the knees according to your convenience, and try to be very confident as if you are sitting in the chair. Few seconds stay. This will really strengthen the knee joints and the thighs, and tone up the total thigh muscles, and it will reduce the fat around your thigh and around your hips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly come back, release. And relaxation. But when you have knee issues or any imbalances around the thighs, this exercise may not suitable to you. Soon after that, wide your legs and close your eyes and lock your hands. Few seconds, long and slow inhalation, exhalation. All right, keep your both the legs together. So before adding the same posture in other variation, let's come into the post stretches. Once fold your right leg to give extra stretch at your thigh forward muscles. Then come back. Opposite side, same practice, fold and stay. 1, 2, 3, all right, 4. Again, few seconds relaxation. Then after that, again, we are doing same Utkutasana, wide leg variation, but it's a body bending variation. All right, now wide your legs. So here, try to bend the knees, but it must be point outside. Keep your toes straight. It's what we call horse stance posture also. Okay, few seconds stay here. Then try to open your right arm to the left side, catch your left thigh and lift your alternate arm up towards opposite side, completely give a bend, and few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and keep open your above hand and slowly release from the strain and relax from the posture. Again, here also post stretches required. And relax your thighs, relax your legs. Okay, take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. So be very convenient and be very confident during the posture as well as pre-positions also. Now wide your legs. Same thing here. Coming to horse stance posture, horse sitting stance. Knees outside, toes straight. Then open your left hand forward and catch your alternate leg. And keep lift your alternate arm and towards your below knee side, bend and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then relaxation is enough. Then very slowly keep open your both hands and lift your body and keep your knees straight and legs together. All right, long and slow and deep inhalation and exhalations. Again, few seconds, rest your legs. Rest your knees. So in post stretches format, you can just move your knees also to give more relaxation at the knee joint and at the thighs. Okay. Now let's coming to the Shirshasana, headstands posture. Maybe few people may show interest to do this headstands posture, but anyone can do these headstands postures. But according to your time limit, according to your convenience and health issues, you can choose proper way of doing. If you have any doubts, please put a comment under this video. I'm requesting my video technician to cover my headstands posture from left side or from right side. Alright, so first thing is, just bend your knees and try to sit properly in the Vajrasana. So this first pre-position. And second pre-position is keeping your both the hands interlock in this way, or you can interlock in this way also. But according to me, I prefer not interlock the fingers by keeping them inside. Just keep two palms one after one. This is easy interlock to me, so that I am giving importance for this interlock. All right, and now try to go for arm bending. Then here try to put your mid part of the head on the support of the two palms, and after that keep lift your body up on the toe support.
Then here slowly walk forward till you are above back to below back straight along with the head line. Then after that fold your one leg and right down. Fold your second leg also down and checking the pre-positions. After that fold your one leg and try to keep lift your knee exactly in the line of the waist. Then slowly keep lift your alternate leg up. Again few seconds check the balance. Again now here also without imbalancing keep your both the knees straight along with your body line. Then here keep open your one leg, keep open your second leg and stay for a while. Throughout this practice try to close the eyes properly because it is not really recommended for the people who are having blood pressure issues, blood pressure issues as well as ear issues, any other severe health ailments. But please remember this posture also called as king of the all postures. So on occasion of Indian Council for Cultural Relations Foundation Day, I'm performing this advanced posture. Right. Here in this same exercise, we have many other variations. And now try to widen your legs and few seconds keep stretch your legs in the same head stance. Then after that, try to lift your one leg up to the 90 degree angle and second leg up to the floor and stay now. And then second variation, then very slowly change your second leg and slowly keep open first leg and second leg. Alright, slowly come back. Now in this same posture, open the arms called Salamba Sirshasana. Again here also, lift your two legs up. And here I am doing Niralamba Sirshasana. Keep open your both the hands till your elbow is straightening. Again, stay for a while. One, two, here also, with that extreme balance, widen your both the legs and few seconds to stay now. One, two, three, four, and five, come back. So lastly, I would demonstrate Padmasana or Lotus posture also. Again, few seconds stay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, enough. 10 relaxations, widen your arms, legs. Then slowly keep down your one leg and second leg. Then after that, slowly drag your legs back, keep your knees down. And after that, keep your both the elbows together. And lift your head, try to rest your head in the Ashwini Mudra Asana, Sheshankasana variation, or Shavasana also. You can do Shavasana also. Then very slowly open your both the hands, then keep your both the hands back, then very slowly keep lift your body, relaxation, you know. So depend on your experience of the Sirshasana and variations, you can choose Shavasana also for relaxation. Okay, let's come into the pranayam. Please remember in Sirshasana also we have many variations, we have many counter poses, but I have chosen counter pose in Ashwini Mudrasana, so my counter pose was done. But according to the people's interest and self experience, you can choose any back bend as a counter pose. Okay, take a long slow deep inhalation and exhalation and choose any convenient posture on any convenient surface. Padmasana, lotus posture or half lotus or Vajrasana or any convenient posture. So before adding pranayam into your schedules, it is also recommended that please give a small time gap after postures to what we call to adjust the breath, to adjust the heartbeat and palpitation, to adjust the body lineup. Okay, long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. So coming to the mantra chanting and sloka chanting for this pranayam. So when you have your traditional belief, you can follow or you can follow only physical exercises. Alright, keep your pranamasana and starting our mantra. Om Kesavaya Swaha.
ओम माधवाय स्वाहा, ओम नारायणाय स्वाहा, ओम अद्य समाधि तत्फल सिद्ध्यर्थम् आसन पूर्वकान् प्राणायामदीं करिष्ये। ओम सैंद 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 ही। And in other words, it is saying that pranayam or yoga postures, breathing exercises, bandhas, mudras, meditations purpose is not only having the good physical energies or physical health or longevity or anti-aging, but it have a definite goal towards spiritual upliftment called what we call nirvana or samadhi state. To reach that level, one should be care about the physical body, one should be care about the mind and social health also. Okay, keeping the practices now here. We have two exercises. One is Surya Bhedana Pranayam, second one is Bhastrika Pranayam. Wind level errors, to control or to clear the wind level, internal wind level errors, these two pranayamas also very good, but we have different other pranayamas. But as a schedule in this week, we are seeing only these two pranayamas. Surya Bhedana calling as Kapala Sodhanam, Vata Doshagnam, Krimi Doshahrut, Punah Punah Ridham Karyam, Surya Bhedana Uttamam. Kapala Sodhanam and Vata Doshagnam means it will check the errors, wind level errors inside the face, as well as it will check the errors body inside the body also, especially wind level errors. Called Vata Doshagnam, completely it will be rectified. This pranayam will be rectified the wind level errors. Krimi Doshahrut means abdominal worms will be killed because of this simple pranayam. But this experience, people will experience this kind of details when you are getting into the practices only. So next one is Bhastrika Pranayam. It is also saying that Vata Pitta Slashma Haram Sarir Agni Vivardhanam Kundali Bodhakam Kshipram Pavanam Sukadam Hitam Brahma Nadi Mukhe Samasta Kapadyargala Nasanam. It is not only good for the wind level errors, also good for the bile level errors, as well as phlegm level errors also, Bhastrika Pranayam. But it has also mentioned that Sarir Agni Vivardhana, metabolic activators or immunity activators. But the people, how we are doing also very important is pranayamas, because inside the pranayamas we have breath holding techniques, retention techniques and bandhas and other mudras also. But initially for the online purpose, online yoga beginners, I'm not using this important advanced techniques. We are doing very simple practices in pranayam. Let's come into the pranayam. Take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. So you can choose holding the knees to keep your spine straight, or when you have awareness on the chin mudra, you can do chin mudra also by turning your palms. And this time open your right hand, last two fingers and right hand thumb called pranayama mudra, and turn towards your face. Your right nostril will receive right thumb, left nostril will receive last two fingers of the right hand. So here close your left nostril and inhalation with the right nostril. And slowly, completely breathe out with the left nostril. Again, inhalation with the right nostril. Do it very slowly, very carefully, but every time fill the lungs and expand the chest. Then after that, slight break. Then after that, slowly breathe out with the left nostril. Again, inhalation with the right nostrils. And exhalation with the left. And today we are doing only three inhalations, three exhalations. Let's coming to the Bhastrika Pranayam. It's a voluntary sharp inhalation, slow exhalation. I'm doing only 15 strokes only. When you have any health related issues, better to take advice from your yoga teacher and physician before starting this kind of practices. Okay, now keep your body straight. Now starting our inhalations, one, then very slowly come back, two, come straight, three, come straight, four, straight, five, straight, six, straight, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, then okay, fuse again, break after your pranayam. But right after your practices, when you know about good practices in dharana practices, are when you know that about the dharana exercises, you can immediately choose dharana practices, or you can choose concentration practices from the trataka formats. And once you will finish your concentration and dharana practices, choose some more time to give relaxation to the body through yoga nidra abhyas or through power naps. Once you will finish your practices, based on the intensity of your practices, based on the strength levels in the practices, it is advised to take 15 minutes time to take bath and further 5 minutes time to take breakfast. In the afternoon, before your lunch hour, I am requesting you all, please try to see all possibilities to take power nap or to do yoga nidra. You can do these practices while sitting in the chairs also. And in the evening, once you will be totally free from your all activities and affairs, and before your dinner time, try to create 15 minutes to half an hour time to do self yoga modules, including back bending exercises and including inverted postures and including like relaxation techniques and breathing techniques also. This is very simple and effective remedy to give yourself healthy living. And on Monday, we are meeting here at the same place, same topics in Ayurveda and in yoga. We will see still more good applications. Again, I'm wishing you all on this auspicious day regarding Indian culture, Indian Council for Cultural Relations Foundation Day. My best wishes to you all. Thanking you all to giving me this wonderful opportunity. Stay away from the bad habits and do yoga also. Thanking you all.